turn the election in Trump's favor.
Do you agree with Andrew McCain that it's possible that this, the president of the United States, the president, is a Russian asset?
Well, the way I completely agree with the way Andy characterized it, you know, that, that it is a possibility. What a great case officer Vladimir Putin is. He knows how to handle an asset, and that's what he's doing with the president.
The president, a Russian asset. Those are the things that Mr. Clapper, the director of national intelligence, said on television. But later in July, when he was being deposed by the House Intel Committee, he said this: I never saw any direct empirical evidence that the Trump campaign or somebody in it was plotting or conspiring with the Russians to meddle with the election. So he said a much different thing behind closed doors. Let's bring in Judge Jeanine Pirro, host of Justice with Judge Jeanine and author of two New York Times bestsellers, Radicals, Resistance, and Revenge, and Liars, Leakers, and Liberals. And Judge, you know, this is something you've been dealing with, writing about for a couple of years. Explain why Mr. Clapper was saying one thing on television, but contradicting it behind the scenes under oath.
Gee, first of all, good morning, everyone. But gee, what a shock. The liars, leakers, and liberals, they actually lied to us, and now we can prove it. They said one thing to try to turn the country against the president of the United States. And yet, when they put their hands on the Bible and had to swear to the truth, they said they knew nothing about Russia collusion or Russia interference. But instead, what they tried to do was create all kinds of chaos in this country, with people actually believing what the garbage that they were spewing. This was a classic example of the swamp in Washington. And we've been talking about a deep state for a long time. It was Brennan and Clapper and McCabe and all of them lying to us, taking dirty dossiers that they knew were not verified, that they were told was Russian disinformation, changing legal documents to get a warrant from a court. They railroaded a three-star general to turn against the president of the United States so that they could change the course of American history. These people are bad, they are corrupt, and they have done everything in their power to create a damage to this country. And thank God we got this information. Right now, the only thing that can happen for the American public to have faith in the Department of Justice and in the FBI is for these people to be accountable. And Adam Schiff, that lying sack of Schiff, this guy who repeatedly would not release information from his House Intel Committee in the basement, the Star Chamber of Congress, he finally had to release information. And when this guy, who's a lawyer allegedly, says that that we have proof of Russia collusion, and every day he pompously goes out there in front of the cameras and says I've got evidence of collusion when he didn't, and he swore that he didn't, this guy needs to lose his license. He needs no longer to be the chairman of that committee, and he needs to be run out of office. This is not the United States of America that our founding fathers created, and it's time for these corrupt bums to get out of office. And number two, as I said in my books, Obama knew. He knew about the counterintelligence investigation. He knew about the fact, because we now know that he, in questioning and talking to Yates and in talking to Cardinal Comey, who was a hardened political operative, knew about the conversation between Flynn and Kislyak, but says so that he could have deniability later. But I don't want to know any more about it. Hogwash. Obama hated Flynn. He hated Flynn because when Flynn worked for him, Flynn didn't buy the Al-Qaeda's on the run after, thank God, President Obama took out that old geezer, Osama bin Laden. The bottom line is that the Al-Qaeda was having training camps in the Middle East and in North Africa. And by the way, Flynn didn't buy the Susan Rice, oh, it was a simple, it was a protest. So they had a mission to get rid of Flynn. And since when do prosecutors say, we're going after him so he can lose his job? And certainly they wanted him to flip. Now, I've been a prosecutor and a judge for 32 years. I am outraged at what happened. And I'll give you one more. I am outraged at the judge who was about to sentence Flynn and said that he was guilty of treason, which is a capital offense. Where did this judge get this information when the FBI in Crossfire Hurricane said there was no derogatory information about Flynn and Russia? These people are bad, they're dirty, they're corrupt, and they're an embarrassment. embarrassment to the United States. And Christopher Wray needs to go too, because he's been sitting there doing nothing.
No derogatory information, no material, derogatory material found on Flynn. CIA said that, FBI said that. And then when they sent those agents into the White House, those agents said that they believed him, that they didn't think he was trying to be dishonest. But Adam Schiff, when he heard about the DOJ dropping the charges, he tweeted this out. He said, Flynn pled guilty to lying to this FBI about his illicit Russian contacts. His lies do not now become truths. This dismissal does not exonerate him, but it does incriminate Bill Barr in the worst politicization of the Justice Department in its history. Your thoughts?
All right. First of all, does anyone even want to listen to what Schiff has to say? I understand the guy for a while was writing theater scripts or something like that. He ought to go back to it. Here's the reason. The reason that he pled guilty was because he pled guilty under duress. He was not given Brady or exculpatory information. And for that bozo to come out and say, hey, look, you know, he pled guilty. No, he didn't. He was forced to plead guilty, and you didn't comply with the Constitution. When McCabe says, hey, you don't need a lawyer, when we know from FBI notes he was a suspect, when they go in violation of policy, of White House policy, and they don't make the appropriate phone calls, and Jim Comey takes off his Cardinal Comey mask and said, hey, we were 4 days in, we could take him out. Cut the crap. You know what? Adam Schiff ought to just stop while he's ahead. He just lies every time he opens his mouth. And thank God for Bill Barr.
Judge, I have to say that you just did your open for your show this weekend. You don't have to tape another. That was perfect. That was the monologue that America wants to hear on Saturday night. And we're going to watch you when Senator Lindsey Graham is going to be live. He might not wear a tie. Larry Kudlow will. He'll be coming to you from the White House from Washington. And Congressman Steve Scalise. That all starts at 9 o'clock on Saturday, featuring the judge. Thanks, Judge.
All right, but I won't be wearing a tie.
You won't be. I hope not. Anyway. Meanwhile, still ahead, President Trump.